Hello, my name is Philip and I'm doing a few videos as first impressions, feedback, 10 to 15 minutes about the Feedback Friday thread on Reddit/gamedev. And the first game is Glide by Inception, which is supposed to be a mobile puzzle game, which you can play in the browser. And he's mostly looking about feedback, if the UI is intuitive and easy to understand. So I think that's perfect for a first impressions video. I have no idea what this is about. I've never played it. I just loaded it up. And I assume it's touch controls, right? Because because it's a mobile game. So, okay. So I basically drag probably the circle in one direction, and I guess the mechanic is it goes to the end which it can reach, and you have to always hit the star. So this, yes. So my first impression there was that I have to click on a field to move the circle, but I guess that's mostly because I'm not playing on mobile and I'm used to more more RTS style games where you would move to some kind of tile. I think so far it's pretty easy to understand. And it's a known concept, right? So this could here, it's too high. Probably need to hit this wall, so we need to come from here. How do we get here? We move. So the first thing I notice is a huge difficulty spike, at least for me, from the previous levels, which are all like one instant look and you know how to solve it, to this, which at least for me is pretty hard. So I can go here. So we have to hit this, right? Because there's no other way to stop the ball on this field otherwise. So we basically have to come from here. So we probably need to end up either here. Yeah, probably here. How do we end up here? We have to go here somehow. Which means we can do this. Ah, okay. Sure, that was pretty hard, honestly. Was a huge difficulty spike, at least for me. So this means we can come from here, we can come... Yeah, we probably can come from here. So we have this. Okay. So I see a solution much easier here, first time, than in the last level. I'm not sure if it's a good solution. I guess it was a pretty good solution. So here we have to come from the right side. Probably end up going here. Because I have the feeling that we rarely used the boundary until now. So we come from here, which means we have to come from here. Which probably means we come from here somehow. Or we come from here and then... No, we can't come from here. Then we would go here. So we have to go here. We have to maybe... So this means... come from here or here. That would mean somehow be here, which I guess would mean we would come from here somewhere, so that might not be the solution. So maybe we have to come from here, but there's no way to stop us. So we can be We can do this, this, this doesn't help. We can do this, 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 this. Go here, go here, go here, go here. Okay, so we can do the long way around. This, 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 here, and go here. Okay, but that's not the optimum solution, which I guess is fine. So this, I guess, is a new mechanic. What's happening? Okay, these things just block you. I don't understand the mechanic from that screen, because I don't see what the difference to just being a wall. So this blocks me. Oh, okay, so it's a new thing I can move. Okay, I think because this looks grayed out, I didn't think I can move it. So that would maybe be one feedback to make it color differently. So this we can just move ahead. Move this path. This is very similar to the first level, so pretty easy to understand that you can move it into that direction. This here means we have to move it here, so we have to move this here, this to this, this back. I think this also is a really good transition to you having to move the blue ball before the gray ball, because the level is very similar to the other one, so you immediately see the small difference, and you don't have to understand the whole level again. I like these levels much more than the ones with the freestanding walls. I think these are, I mean, they are way easier, I guess, but still pretty good. So we want to have something here, right? So we can put something here and then something into there. So the way we can do this is move this there. I guess, move this to this. Okay, this probably doesn't work, okay. Yes. Oh yeah, of course, we can just do this. Which is also, like, that was more of my fault. This was pretty easy to understand, I feel. Here again, we need to come from here. So we need some way of going to this wall, which I guess in this instance means the gray ball needs to be either here or here. So we can come from the top or the bottom. We can get the blue ball in here, then we can get... So we can get the blue ball... Oh, we can't, of course. Okay, never mind. I fucked that up. So we can get the blue ball in here by doing this. Then we can not get this in here anymore. We could put the blue ball here, put the gray ball in like this, put the blue ball here, gray ball here. But then we can... Oh, we can just put the gray ball here. This wall really tricked me up. But I managed it in the end. So this means we have to come from either here or we have to put a ball to this side. We can put the blue ball here, then put the gray ball here. And then we put the blue ball here again. Okay, let's try that. So we put this one here, put this one here. Blue ball does a long walk around. Okay. Wow, that was really bad. So I kind of missed something there, I guess. This one we can come from here, or we could put the gray ball somewhere here. This again is very similar to the other level, so I guess if I would have solved the other level correctly, I probably have a way easier time. I guess I actually can Nope, that wasn't what I wanted at all. So I can put the blue ball here, which I don't want to do, but I can put this one here and then it goes a long way around. Which is still not optimum, but okay. So this time we probably need to come from the top, I guess, and go down, or come from here and get out. So we can put this one here, put the blue one here. Can put the blue one here, and then this one can go here. So we can actually use a lot of moves to put the gray one below. No, I can't even. I can move it to the left. I could move it up. Can move. Let's restart this. What does the undo button do actually? Oh, okay, it just undoes the last move. Okay, that would have been very helpful. I didn't really look for that, so I think the UI is very clear. So what do we want to do here? We can put the gray ball here, which means we can... Oh, of course. We can do this, this. Did I want to do that? I wanted to put this here, so we can do this, this, this. Ah. Okay, I made it, but probably in too many moves. Okay, pretty cool. I tried to keep these videos around 10 minutes, so I'll stop here, but it's actually quite a fun game. I like the minimalist art style. I think the target is very clear, the first ball is very clear. Like I said, I would give this ball another color, since it's... I see why it's grayed out, because you can't win with it, but I feel if it would have, I don't know, a different color, it would still be pretty clear, because the star is also blue. And it would mean the initial reaction wouldn't be, oh, I can't move this, because it's grayed out, but it would be more, okay, oh, this is a second object I can interact with. Yeah, otherwise, I think it's pretty cool. Oh, and I see all my levels and so on. Good, I nearly finished the basics. So, yeah. Thanks for watching.